Good morning, students. During this time of a lockout, I'm sure you are very safe at home along with your parents, but at the same time we are not going to lose any study. So from our school's point of view, I have already started sending you the worksheets of grammar. One poem was sent through PowerPoint presentation, and I have received some good reports from that. Today I'm uploading one video of another poem. The name of the poem is Fire and Ice. It is written by Robert Frost. Now, the poem has some very different kind of ideology to be understood, and that ideology is through which element the world will come to an end. We all know that the human beings are very greedy. Human beings are innovative also. Human beings are creative also. But it so happens that in most of the cases, the greed of the human being, that might as well lead to some sorts of destruction. And it may happen that the world may come to an end. Sooner or later, yes, it is going to happen, maybe in another million years or 500 million years. No, nobody knows about it. But humans who rule over the planet called Earth, they should be careful. They should be careful in a way that they should understand that they should control their desire, their lust, their greed. Fire and Ice is a poem in which the poet wants to explain that the world may come to an end. It may come to an end, or the earth may get destroyed, maybe by fire or maybe by ice. It can be a geographical event. Fire, in case some huge meteor may struck on the earth, and the way all the dinosaurs perished or vanished from this earth, maybe the earth may get destroyed due to this fire. Or maybe the ice age may come back again and our life can come to an end. So both are just competent enough to bring the world to a catastrophic end. But here fire and ice is symbolized differently. Fire is compared with the desire, and desire is your wish. But when your wish becomes intense, that intensity of the wish is converted into desire. Initially you may have wish gets converted into want gets converted into demand, demand gets converted into desire. This is the flow. Let me read poem from my laptop over here, and let's go stanza by stanza explanation. Fire and Ice by Robert Frost. Some say the world will end in fire, some say in ice. From what I've tasted of desire, I hold with those who favor ice. Now here, desire, it means a strong wanting to have something, or wishing for something to happen. There is another word over here. That word is favor. What is favor? F-A-V-O-U-R. It is an approval or support. So the explanation says that the poem, it expresses the profound idea that world would end in either of two ways, either by ice or fire. One group is of the opinion that someday the earth's core will get so heated that it will lead to fire and it will destroy the earth. Whereas the other have a different view, that will come back into the second stanza. Fire and ice, they both are destructive features of human emotions. Ice is compared to hatred, and fire is compared to desire. Desire and hatred, they both are destructive forces, and they may lead to the end of a very human race. He says that from what he is aware about the fiery desires, he would favor the ones who say that it would be fire that will bring to an end. And by saying so, he brings about an idea that human beings let their emotions rule them, and then the consequences of unemotional longing is a chaos, literal chaos actually. No person can live without desire, that is sure. Now the second part of the poem, second stanza of the poem, has a different ideology. But if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough of hate to say that for destruction eyes is also great and would suffice. Perish. Here perish's meaning is death, die. Suffice, short form of sufficient. Word says that by not waving of the first option of the fire, he is not completely rejecting the idea of fire. But he considers that world has to expire twice. If the world has to expire twice or to die twice, then fire, along with the fire, ice is also equally powerful force. The stanza says that from what I have tasted desire, I hold with those who favor a fire, but if it had to perish twice, I think I know enough hate to say that for destruction eyes, it also great and would suffice. So even ice is sufficient enough to put an end to the world. There is no perfect answer that which one of these is good enough to perish the world. He has waved off his first idea. He brings about a contrast between ice and hatred, the human capability of insensitivity is highlighted over here, and that's where the poem comes to an end. In my second part, I'll explain to you about the literary part of it. We'll also discuss about some questions and answers in it. Thank you very much for watching this.